Good morning. The current weather is 29 degrees Fahrenheit with partly cloudy skies. Today's forecast has mostly sunny weather, with a high of 49 degrees and a low of 29 degrees.
What?
Good morning.
Hey, Bookadoo! What's up, Sugar Lips? Hey!
My breakfast is already ready. I don't have to worry about that. It's already done. It is 9:04. I'm about to go downstairs because I want to get my paperwork printed out. Make sure I clock in on time. It's still a little chilly, so I'm taking this hat with me because I like this multicolored hat. And I'm going to wear these glasses because... Oh, you know what? No, I'm not. I'm going to wear these because they kind of look like they go with my shirt. Hold on. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right, so I'm about to gather my breakfast. What shoes am I wearing? I guess I could wear the ones, the black ones or whatever. Okay, as long as I'm comfortable. Y'all hear that? That's the dryer. The washing machine has a longer melody. Like, it be going, you can start like gigging. You can start be like, hey. All right, so I'm about to go downstairs, get my life together. My regional manager is going to be here today. Interviewing two people. I don't know if he's doing it virtually or if he is interviewing them in person. People haven't done in-person interviews in a long time, but my company does virtual interviews quite a bit. I'm hoping that the interviews go well because I need a person here so I can take some time off. And I can have my days off. I really don't want to work extra days, but I will if they need me to, you know. But I don't prefer that. So let me get myself downstairs and I'll hit y'all up a little bit when I go outside. I'm gonna show y'all a few things. I had to do that. So the infamous camper that when I got here was sitting in the wrong spot, it has to be towed to another spot. Now, typically the cars and the campers and stuff out here should be drivable. So it should be where the person can come move it and not that it has to be towed. So I'm gonna have to have a conversation with that tenant. And then it's a couple of other situations out here that I need to take care of because y'all can probably see it from here. It's a vehicle that has tarps on it, but they are towed up and it looks horrible. You see that? That needs to be another kind of cover put on it because it, and then all of what happens with those tarps, they start flying everywhere and it's like little strings all over the property. So he's gonna, or she, I don't even know who owns it. I've never seen them before. They're gonna have to come and recover that with something else or get a new tarp because that has gone through the winter time and it's all tow up. Hold on. I don't know how they gonna do this. Maybe he gonna pull it through. I'm very curious. I guess he's gonna pull ahead and then back it in. That's some maneuvering right there. That's some real maneuvering. Look at that big boy. Look at that big boy. Oh, y'all, he's gonna back it in. Cause it's gotta go in that spot right. experience. So, I just want to take a quick moment to talk about this dude, cool man, cool young man, this guy right here. He was one of my tenants when I was at Schaefer Storage, and older guy, always wore a suit. I mean, Steve Harvey ain't got nothing on this guy, right? Very nice. He was one of my favorite tenants, period. Okay? Always very nice to me. He would, you know, sometimes forget to pay his bill. And, you know, I would call him. And he, you know, he'd be like, hey, sweetheart. You know, he was so smooth and sweet. And even after I stopped working there, I would call him every once in a while and see how he was doing. And he had been on my mind and he was on my mind in December and I couldn't reach him. You know, I called, but you know, and I got a message today from Dan over at Schaefer Storage that he passed away. He sent me a text message with his name on it, you know, and it said, rest in peace. And I was like, what? Are you kidding me? And I looked it up online because he was kind of famous, okay? He was a jazz musician, a singer, and he was very good friends with Aretha Franklin. And so I looked his name up and it came up right away. His funeral was on YouTube. It just came up right away. And I'm like, wow. So that's three people in a week's time that I have found out have passed away that I know. It's just rough. You know what I'm saying? It makes me stutter. So it's rough. It kind of puts a damper on your week. And, you know, my birthday's coming up, and my uncle asked me today, am I excited? And I told him, not really. And he said, I'm confused. And I said, well, you know, what? It's just been, it's been a rough couple of weeks, you know, getting this news, and it just kind of like knocks you down, you know. And I don't know what else to say, but, you know, he was 88 years old. I hope he rests in peace. And, you know, he was a really good guy, you know, very, very, very respectful, you know. And he always would check on me, you know, and I appreciate that man, you know what I'm saying? So, here's a little something, just a little bit, you know, if you want to look him up. His name is Norman Thrasher from Detroit, Michigan. You'll see quite a few things on YouTube. And, you know, he had an interview with Channel 4 News when Aretha Franklin passed away. And just a real good guy. So, you know.
Man who's already been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Already inducted into the Rhythm and Blues Hall of Fame. Goes a long way back. Hank Ballard and the Midnighters. Taught Chubby Checker how to do the twist. And older than me. So would you please put your hands together and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Norman Thrasher.
Regional manager, he had two interviews scheduled today. He got here, started getting ready for him. The one girl hit him up and was like, I can't come, I got COVID. I'm like, Lord have mercy. So then the second guy, he's like, okay, well, I got one more, and, you know, that's not the end for her. You know, we can interview virtually, and, you know, when she gets better, we can go from there. And I'm like, yeah, that's true. So then, right before the other guy was supposed to come, he contacts him. He's like, nah, bro. I'm in Detroit. Because we ain't in Detroit. We out far in the country. He was like, with these gas prices, nah, I'm not going to be able to do this. And I understand. They are approaching $5, the gas prices, for not even premium. Hey, who want to be driving from Detroit? Because, hey, I tell, hey, baby, my first two, no, my first month here, I drove from Detroit out here. That ain't no cute ride. I mean, the weather's getting better and everything, but gas is higher, huh? And honestly, don't nobody want to commute that far. Not every day, huh? Especially not if it's going to be a part-time position. So, kind of back to the drawing board with one, you know. And I might have to work 6 days for a couple of weeks, you know. Which I don't have a problem with that. You know, knowing it ahead of time. That last minute stuff is what be kicking my butt. But other than that, that's it. I am excited to get some birthday cake. Because I've been wanting some, you know. But again, I appreciate y'all for tuning in. I'm sorry, you know, it's just been rough. I wasn't taking no clips or nothing the last few days, hardly, because I just ain't feel like it, you know. But I'm here, and see y'all on the next video.
Ain't nobody finna keep adulting like this. I'm not finna keep being an adult. I'm not finna do it. You see how these kids living right now? Having the best time of their life. While we going through shit. We up and down like a roller coaster. Depression, anxiety. You almost. You see? And this mother. Hey. Nah, for real. I'm not finna keep being an adult. Why these kids finna live out my life dreams by the time they 13? This ain't finna keep going like this. I'm telling you right now. His eyes get watery when you tell him no, he can't have no snack.
Ooh, you made it. But make sure you thumb this up, comment, subscribe, and share.